After suffering through two subpar seasons, Shelton High School has come all the way back this year. The Gaels already own the Housatonic League title with an 8-0 mark. Now only Derby stands between Shelton and a perfect conference ledger for 1991. Quarterback Dan Field and tailback John Eason lead the balanced Shelton offense. Fullback Bob Ayer keeps the defenses honest with his inside running, while Field likes to throw to wideouts Dave Peterson and Darren Unfricht. Derby High School has not had a losing record in football since 1963. The 5-5 Raiders need a win over Shelton to maintain that unbelievable streak. Quarterback Ben Bartone is back at the controls for the Big Red after sustaining an early season arm injury. Bartone will try to mix the pass with the run and keep Shelton off balance. John Potke and Dave and Roman key the Derby running game. From Ryan Field and Derby, it's Shelton against Derby in the 81st renewal of this Thanksgiving Day Classic on Telemedia Sports Valley High School Football Game of the Week. Again, everyone, Ed Clements, Buddy Chernovitz from here at Ryan Field in Derby. Buddy, let's talk about Ben Bartone and that quarterback situation for the Derby Red Raiders. He has played in the last couple of games that the Raiders have had, but frankly, there's been a problem at times with the full range of motion in that left wrist, the forearm, that is healed, but there might be a problem with that snap at times, and that's something that we could look for early on in this football game.
That'll be a key offensively to the ability of Derby to be in this football game. Ben Bartone's had problems, as you just said, Eddie, in getting the snap from center. He's got to be able to get the snap, the exchange, and the ability of Ben Bartone to run this football team is key to the Derby win if they're going to win today.
Now, when you talk about Shelton, the first person you always talk about is John Eason, and why not? Then you talk about the senior quarterback, Dan Field. He has had a great 1991 season. I'd like to focus in a little bit on their fullback, the junior fullback, Bob Ayer. Not only does he provide that inside running game for the Gaels, but lately they have thrown to him coming out of the backfield. It's just another weapon for Shelton.
They certainly do. Eason keeps you honest all the way across the field. Ayer is able to run the ball inside also to catch that football, and Field has been able to do what he's had to do, not only throwing the football, but running it. They've got an awful lot on offense. The ability of Derby to control Eason and Ayer and to keep Field from making big plays is going to be very important if Derby is going to get a W in this football game.
Now, when I talked to both coaches, they both started with defense. First of all, Coach Charlie DeCenzo, he said, hey, his club has got to keep Shelton to two scores or less. The other side, Tony Brinker, frankly doesn't know what Coach Charlie DeCenzo is going to do. So he has had his defense prepare for just about anything, and he's looking for early game adjustments by his coaching staff.
Yeah, Derby played the wing T starting out with Ben Bartone, then they went to the I a little bit, and they moved around in offensive looks, and it's certainly going to be a key as to how the Shelton Gaels are able to defense Derby. Derby wants to come out and to be able to control the ball, to have a bit of ground attack, also to allow Bartone to throw the ball if he can. If Derby can do that, it's going to be an interesting football game. The paper says that the Shelton Gaels should win this game. They've got a great record coming in, but tradition, the fact that Derby needs this to have a winning season, sort of makes this football game a kind of unpredictable situation.
And what do you think each team has to do in this football game to win?
They got to score more points than the other team. First of all, if you do that, you're going to get the W. Derby's got to be able to do it by way of the air as much as on the ground. Shelton Gaels, I think, would just like to run the football, throw when they have to. It's going to be interesting to see which group of young men come out here more emotionally ready to play. I think that's going to play a role in this game. The team that's emotionally high, the team that gets a couple breaks that can convert those breaks is going to be a winner here. I throw the record book out in this game. This game is just a downright backroom brawl, and both teams, they play aggressive football, so the team that wants it the most is going to win.
We'll be back with Derby Shelton football right after these words. Welcome back, everyone. Moments away from the opening kickoff, the 81st renewal between Shelton and Derby, Thanksgiving Day 1991. The Gaels won the opening coin toss, but they have deferred their option to the second half. Derby will receive to open the football game. O'Patterney to kick it off end over end, and that is to Shepard. And Shepard takes the ball out to the 36-yard line. It'll be first down, first and 10 for the Derby Red Raiders. underway from here at Ryan Field. Let's take a look first at that Derby offense. In the backfield, of course, the co-captain Ben Bartone, such an integral part of that Derby offense. On the line, a couple of changes on that offensive line. Sean Bittman in at center in place of starting center Lou Gattano. Gattano was hurt during practice during the week. And another change, George Hay has moved to the left tackle from right guard, and they've inserted Angelo DeRuba, a sophomore, at right guard. First down for the Raiders underway here in this Thanksgiving Day battle. That is Potke, stood up by the Shelton defense on the first down carry for the Raiders. Rob Johnson on the tackle from his outside linebacker spot. Let's take a look now at that. Let's take a look now at that Shelton defense while we get a chance. And Shelton, you'll notice defensively, is really going to be coming out at the start of this game to prepare against the pass. Coach Tony Branca feels that the Raiders will put the football up about 20 times in this football game.
Dominic Bowana was starting at quarterback, so Bartone is not in there as the Derby Red Raiders go to a throw right away.
On a halfback option pass, and that is enrollment on the halfback option, and it is incomplete. Shepard was the intended receiver, unfricked on the coverage for the Gales.
Bowana will just take the ball, throw the pitch back, and allow enrollment to throw the option pass. Well covered by the Derby, or by the Shelton Gales, well overthrown, no chance to complete it. Brings up a big 3rd and 9 in their first possession for the Derby Red Raiders. Again, coming into the game now, Ben Bartone, as they go to a shotgun.
It's possible that this is what they're going to be doing all morning long here at Ryan Field, as we have movement on both sides of the line of scrimmage. And 3rd and long, Ben Bartone, and as Buddy mentioned, in the shotgun formation as Bowano was in on the first two downs for Derby. There's Dickie Hildebrand signaling the penalty against the Raiders.
Awful lot of movement. The center obviously not on the same page with Ben Bartone, as the ball was never snapped. Front moved along with the backs. It'll bring up a 3rd and about 15 now for the Red Raiders. Their offense trying to get into sync as they are now with Ben Bartone behind the core center for the first time.
Two wideouts at the left side, obvious passing formation, and he wings it for a completion to Shepard, but Shepard is hit as he gets the football at the 35-yard line, and it's going to be a kicking situation. Again, Rob Johnson on the tackle for the Shelton Gales.
Picked up about 5, just a quick turnout as Bartone takes the shotgun snap and then just throws about a 4 or 5 yarder right over the middle. Well covered by Shelton. It'll bring up a 4th down in a punting situation for Derby.
Mike Potke will be punting the football away, and single safety for the Gales is Dave Peterson, standing at his 30-yard line. Just underway, Ryan Field, a gorgeous day for high school football, Thanksgiving 1991. Peterson just gets away from the football, and it's going to roll dead at about the 40-yard line. Let's take a look while we have an opportunity at that Shelton Gale offense. It's been a diversified offense, of course, in the backfield. The senior quarterback, Dan Field, behind him in the eye is Bob Ayer and John Eason. And when you look at that line, Buddy, it's a line that has basically been together 2 to 3 years. And when I look at kids like Sylvester and D'Agostine and Bobby, they have been 3-year starters.
It's a big group of young men, and they opened some gaping holes in that defense.
Well, that time there wasn't a gaping hole, because Eason is snowed under on the first down carry. Ferrigno from his linebacker spot. Let's look now at that Derby Red Raider defense, and this is something that Coach DeCenzo has really stressed to me during the week. He needs a big, big effort from his defense.
They cannot allow Eason to get outside and to run free, and they've got to contain air inside, and it's going to be a job for these young men from Derby if they're going to win this football game to contain those two running backs.
Ball is at the 40. It's a 2nd and 9 for the Raiders. And Field gives to Eason, and Eason is spilled after a pickup of 3 as he slants off the left side, again from the inside backer spot. Ferrigno, 6 foot, 190-pound senior linebacker on the stop.
Eason just comes over to the left side. It's a little bit of a sprint draw. Good job containing by Derby, as along the front they are doing an excellent job of getting rid of the blockers. Picked up about 3. It'll bring up about a 3rd and 6, as you see the large number of people here on a beautiful, beautiful Thanksgiving morning watching this traditional battle between the Shelton Gales and Derby Red Raiders.
Those fans you got to look on the other side of the field, on the Shelton side, they were there a full hour before the football game. Field throwing out to the near sidelines, and Peterson makes an effort to come up with the football at the 30. Cannot get to it. It's incomplete. Shepard on the coverage for the Raiders, and it'll be a kicking situation for the Shelton Gaels.
Field will get outside, has a lot of time to throw the ball, and then just does not connect on this down and out. And then turning up the sidelines, the intended receiver unable to get to it. Brings up a fourth and a punting situation, as Shelton is unable to get a first down in their first possession. The same as the Derby Red Raiders.
I think, buddy, we can say that these are normal occurrences at the beginning of a football game. You're feeling out your opponent.
Going to have a penalty here, and it'll bring up a situation where Coach Branken knows he's going to be fourth and about one. Derby went offsides on the snap. They violated the neutral zone. And it's going to be interesting now to see Coach Branken. He'll be very close to about the 48-yard line, his own 48, as to what he will do with this one.
Fourth down.
It's a little more than one. It's about 2 yards now, and I don't think he's going to change. Coach Branken will leave that punt team in.
They have a lot of faith in that defense, and they should come out of it with Derby pinned deep in their own territory. Fetty gets off the punt, and it's going to roll dead inside the 20-yard line. We've got a break in the action with no score. Welcome back, everyone. Buddy caught up with Coach Branken before the game, and he asked the Shelton coach about the question surrounding the Derby's Ben Bartone, and how has this affected Shelton's preparation for this football game?
Yes, it has, Bud. If people have watched Derby throughout the year, you've seen them play many different types of offenses and many different styles of defenses, and that made for a very rough week and a half of practice because we had to prepare ourselves for almost anything they could throw at us. And still at this point, we really don't know what they're going to come out with. So I think that our coaching staff has to get together real quick in the beginning of the game to make those adjustments so that we can make a game of it today.
We're back, everyone. There is head football coach Tony Branken completing his fourth year as the head coach at Shelton High School. First down for the Raiders inside their 20. We're still in the first quarter. There is no score. Shotgun on first down. Bartone is the quarterback. Under a rush, wings it out over the center of the field. There's a little bumping going around. It's intercepted by Darby right in front of us. And let's now await that call.
Intercepted by Shelton Gaels. Great day flag on the play.
Eddie, that ball was thrown up for grabs. Not really a well-thrown football. It's going to go against the Red Raiders, the pass interference. The Shelton Gaels are going to get a big turnover here. Bartone just rolls a little bit to his left and then throws a skyrocket, but well covered by the Shelton Gaels, right at about the 42-yard line. Shelton will take over inside Derby territory on the turnover, the interception from Bartone.
So Darby comes up with the interception for the Gaels, and they are in business at the 42-yard line of the Raiders.
That's something Derby cannot afford to do. They've got to force Shelton to go a long distance if they're going to score. They have given them excellent field position right at the 42.
Derby in a 4-4 defense. Field throwing on first down, a short pass to the sidelines, incomplete out of his receiver's hands there, and that receiver was Dave Peterson, Lord on the coverage for the Raiders.
Just a turnout. Peterson will turn at the sidelines. Field tries to get him the football. Not badly thrown football, just unable to be handled by Peterson on the sideline. It'll bring up a second and 10 for the Gaels.
Out to the left side is Darren Unfricht, and to the bottom part of your screen, that is Peterson. The I formation for the Gaels on second and 10. Eason breaks a tackle. 35, 30. He's got a clear field ahead of him. John Eason for the Shelton touchdown. Eason bounced off a tackle inside the 40-yard line, and then he broke free at the 30. He's off to the races for the junior running back.
Eason will just step out of some tackles here as he will break it back to the near sideline after he gets across the line of scrimmage. Right here he comes back toward us and just outruns people into the end zone. Some good blocking along that line of scrimmage and in the secondary. John Eason, 42 yards, opens the scoring here with 7:37 left to go in this first quarter. The Shelton Gaels on the board first here at Derby.
Encroachment penalty on the extra point attempt against the Raiders. That'll move the football a yard and a half closer to the goal line. Shelton apparently going to go for that one. Holder is Field and O'Patterney to kick. Matt O'Patterney. The kick is up, and it is good. And the Shelton Gaels lead it in the first quarter here at Ryan Field by a score of 7-0. Buddy Chernovitz caught up with Coach Charlie DeCenzo before the football game. He noted that that the Derby quarterback, Ben Bartone, was back, but not 100%. And he asked the veteran Derby coach what adjustments Derby has had to make offensively.
But we're going to be a radically different team today. You know, Ben's strength is a thrower, and we're going to try to throw the ball. And, of course, it kind of complements. I mean, Shelton is an extremely physical team up front, and, you know, we probably would have had some trouble running the ball anyway. So we're coming in kind of like with a wide-open game plan, and we're hoping that that'll help Ben a little bit and some of our receivers. And it's not a typical they used to call me ground chuck. We're not going in with that philosophy. I hope it works for us, buddy.
We're back, everyone. Charlie DeCenzo. For the Derby Red Raiders, Charlie completing his ninth year as the head football coach here at Derby. What a great record for Coach DeCenzo. Last year, of course, all the way to the Class S championship game against the Housatonic Regional, and the number one spot in both the writers and the coaches polls. Of course, there were a lot of expectations, but a lot of injuries this year for the 1991 season for the Raiders. But all will be forgotten if the Raiders come out on top in this football game. Of course, the Gaels, on the other hand, undefeated in Housatonic League play. They've already won the championship. But you got to think that they would feel a little bit short of their goals if they didn't come out with a victory here at Ryan Field. It's
this
a traditional
is the one
game.
You remember. The one you take home is this football game, especially Derby Shelton. It's traditional. It can cure an awful lot of ills in that season with a W in today's game. And right now, the Shelton Gaels have certainly started off on the right foot. John Eason into the end zone early in this first quarter following the interception of a Ben Bartone pass. Great field position. Took him three plays to get in. And we'll see now if the Red Raiders can answer back offensively. Last series, they went strictly to the shotgun formation. Started with Dominic Bowano and then have now gone to Ben Bartone, a quarterback, and it'll be interesting to see whether the Derby football team will continue to try and almost exclusively throw the football out of the shotgun or whether they'll have Dominic Bowano behind the quarterback. The reason Dominic Bowano is taking snaps is because Ben Bartone is unable, as Coach DeCenzo just told you, unable really to get the snap and for them to be sure that he can make the play without the possibility of a fumble. So it's been a tough decision for the Derby football team, but they are going with that in today's game.
O'Patterney's kickoff, that is to Shepherd. And Shepherd, the center of the field, and Shepherd across the 30 to about the 31-yard line, where the Raiders will go on offense their third possession of the football game. They're going to have to establish something as Bartone comes into the lineup.
Shepherd will kind of dance a little bit. He is not very aggressive getting in there. Brings it back to the 31-and-a-half-yard line, and the Red Raiders will start there with their third possession here in this first quarter.
Well, every time Bartone is in, it's been shotgun for the Raiders. Two wideouts to the left side, and Ben is rolling, looking over the middle, under pressure, has a receiver out there. It is a catch by Ferrigno in traffic. And the senior tight end takes the football close to a first down. Unfricked along with Fetty combine on the tackle.
Little bit of a half roll to the left by Bartone, and then he does a good job of getting the ball over in traffic. Ferrigno makes a good catch, short of the first down by about a yard, but it is a great throwing catch from Ben Bartone to his tight end Ferrigno as he comes across the middle.
Buddy, I got to think that Derby's got to go short because the Shelton line, it's a big line defensively, and he's going to need time to throw the football, even from the shotgun. Inside handoff out of that shotgun, that is Potke, who was standing beside Bartone. Nicholas and Rob Johnson on the stop for the Gaels as let's await that spot. It might be a first down for the Raiders.
It's going to be close as the handoff from Bartone to Potke as he just tries to get over that left side. Good job by Shelton in closing it off. They only gave up a yard and a half, but that was enough for the first down for the Derby Red Raiders, and that's their first one of this football game.
Telemedia Sports, our Valley High School football game of the week. Football at the 42, still in the first quarter, Ryan Field and Derby. This Housatonic League finale between these two traditional rivals. It is picked off. That is Fetty. at the 40, the 30, the 20, and tackled inside the 15-yard line. Fetty playing center field out of his safety spot, picks off Bartone, and Shelton is in business again.
Fetty just steps in front of this ball as Bartone tries to again get the ball down the field. Fetty just right in front of the intended receiver and then down to the 20-yard line. He really has great coverage. Potke behind is going to drag him down at about the 20, but Fetty brings it down inside the 20 to the 11-yard line. A great interception return by Brian Fetty. Great field position for Shelton. Their third possession, this one on the 11-yard line of the Derby Red Raiders.
Peterson swings wide out to the right side. The pitch, that is to Eason, to the long side of the field. Eason inside the 10-yard line. He is short tackled there by Potke, the sophomore safety. Mike Potke, that is, younger brother of John.
Just coming on a toss, trying to get Eason outside. Bobby Ayer with the lead block, but Derby does a good job. You see Lord there turning Eason inside and closing him down at about the 9.
Twins out to the left side, that is Unfricked along with Peterson, out of your picture, as they run the fullback, Bob Ayer inside the 5 to the 4. And Housatonic League rivals, they have Ayer and Eason to look forward to next year. They're both going to be back for Shelton.
Ayer just comes over the right side on a little bit of a belly. He finds a good hole, gets himself inside the 4-yard line. Nose of the football over the 4. It'll bring up a third and very short, about 2 yards for that first down, 4 yards for the touchdown. Early in this first quarter, and the Shelton Gaels are ready to maybe blow this game open very early.
Split backs. On a little bit of misdirection, they give to Ayer, and Bob Ayer, the junior fullback, brings it into the end zone.
Ayer just comes on that little bit of a draw, 4 yards for the touchdown. Watch as he will just come on a little bit of a delay, back over the right side again, and he is in the end zone, following Blanchett, Bobby, and Gaddis right in, and it's a very quick 13-0 football game, 4-10 left to go. I think it's 4:40, tough to see, but about 4:40 left to go in this first quarter.
O'Patterney with that one-step form, and Matt drills it through the uprights, and Shelton has gone up on top of Derby early on, 14-0.
The next series, Eddie, is going to be extremely critical to Derby. They have had 2 turnovers, interceptions. Fetty, the last one, the 2 interceptions that have put the Derby defense in a tough position. The Shelton Gaels have been able to take advantage of that great field position with 2 scores. Only in this first quarter, they are up 14-0. The Derby Red Raiders have got to do something positive on offense. They've got to get a drive together. They cannot afford to give the Gaels back the football in this first quarter and allow them to get into the end zone again, or this football game will be history here in this first quarter. The Shelton defense is not going to give up 3 touchdowns to Derby today.
Well, as I talked to you about in the pregame show, I did say that Coach DeCenzo was hoping that his defense would hold him to 2 scores. There's your 2 scores. That would mean that he's going to have to shut out Shelton for the remainder of this game. Everyone knows Derby has had their offensive problems in the second half, and that's mainly due to the injuries that they've had. Shepard, center of the field.
He lost that pigskin.
Fumble, and that's picked off. It's the Gaels that have fallen onto it. I think that's Piscineri, number 78.
And the worst scenario of events have just taken place for the Red Raiders, and that is another turnover, this time at their own 35-yard line, as Shepard had the ball ripped out of his hands. As he comes back up the middle, you see Lord lead him, and then watch the ball just be ripped away right here. You'll see the arm come in. Number 89 is going to get credit for that. He just knocked the football right out of the hands of Shepard. Shelton has recovered, and they are right on the 34-yard line looking for blood at this point in the game.
That might have been Nedovaska. Nedovaska came up with the loose ball. And Field airs it out on first down. On the other end, it is picked off by the Raiders. Dave and Roman on the interception. So Field went up on top on first down, and Roman intercepted for the Raiders.
The Shelton Gaels return the favor as Field tries to go to the outside. They try and get the big one right away. And then the ball is a little bit short, and the interception by the Derby Red Raiders a first down inside the 15 at about the 13-yard line, and that is a big, big defensive play for the Red Raiders. But now they've got to do something with that offense. They've got to get some yardage from that goal line and some first downs.
Out of the shotgun, the co-captain, Ben Bartone, getting it out to Enrollman. Enrollman at the 10. Tackled there by Rob Darby. Fine defensive effort by Darby because Enrollman had some open room ahead of him and an open field.
Darby does a good job on coverage. And Roman swings out on the little bit of a delay or screen, and then Darby, the only guy left to make the tackle, makes it, and it's a big, big play defensively for the Gales as they stop Derby right at about the line of scrimmage.
Second and 10 now coming up for the Raiders, so play that could have gone for some good yardage for Derby. Stopped at the line of scrimmage with Darby's defensive play. Second and 10 out of the shotgun, Bartone. Has an open Shepherd. Shepherd at the 20 and gets close to the yardage for the first down. He'll be shy of it. Bob Ayer from the linebacker spot on the tackle for the Gales.
Again, just a little bit of a turnaround pattern, turnaround in the middle. Bartone trying to go to Shepherd. Picked him up close to that first down. It'll be a third and one. Potke blocking in the backfield. Bartone hits Shepherd. Shepherd does a good job getting over the 20 to about the 23 and a half. Very close to that first down. They still need a yard. Big play for the Red Raiders.
Derby has both their wide receivers, Lord and Shepherd, to the left side. And they hand off to Potke. Potke, the near sidelines.
That one's
the first down and outside the 40.
That one's going to come back, Eddie. There was movement, I think, at the top of the picture. We'll see. I guess not. They're going to catch a break here. The right end had a little bit of movement before the snap of the football. Bartone gives the ball to Potke. He finds some running room over this near side and gets up the field for a big, big play for the Red Raiders as they are across their own 40 to about the 41-yard line. Their second first down of the football game.
This has been a long first quarter.
A lot of throwing, Edward, incompletions. You'll get that in a football game when you have the stoppage of the clock.
Football at the 41.
Wow.
The snap is over Bartone's head. He picks it up. Let's see if he just gets it off. He does. It's going to be ruled an incompleted pass because Enrollman was in the area, and that has saved the gigantic loss for the Raiders. The presence of mind, Bartone's throwing the football away.
Not only throwing it, but he was throwing it to a receiver, and Roman was not that far away from the football. Bartone gets a good hop on the ball, picks it up, and gets the ball down the field. He's an outstanding baseball player. Use that talent right there. As you saw, Ian Roman was close to it to prevent the grounding because all Ben Bartone wanted to do was to get rid of it, prevent the big loss on the sack. He does that, keeps the Red Raiders at the 41, second down.
Second down, shotgun formation. Bartone, second and 10. A flag is dropped by the official on the far side. Someone might have lined up in that neutral zone. That's it. It was the Gales, and that's going to be assessed 5 yards against the Gales, moving the football to the 46. Telemedia Sports, a Valley High School football game of the week. This year, Shelton Derby football on Thanksgiving. Happy to send it along to you. Look out on the field. The crowd is just fantastic, lined all around the field, and all the bleachers are completely filled. Second and 5 for the Raiders. Another high snap. The ball is juggled there, and Bartone under an avalanche inside the 40-yard line. Sawyer, Chobbs.
They're going to have to get together on that snap because Ben Bartone prevented another bad one right there as the ball goes way upstairs. Watch him get up and knock the ball down. He's unable to hold on to it. Well, able again to get the good hop, but he is going to get drilled as he picks it up.
So a third and 11, the football at the 39-yard line for the Raiders. Shelton playing pass, and Derby basically going to a passing game against the Gales. Bartone looking for a receiver, has one out there. It's caught for the first down in traffic down at the 45-yard line. Shepherd
Shepard comes across the middle. Again, Bartone with a pretty good snap stands in there. He will step up and throw a strike to Shepard as he comes across for the first down. Excellent throw catch again for the Derby Red Raiders as Derby will take a timeout right here. That is the eighth pass by Derby there, 5 for 8. Ben Bartone, 5 for 8 in this football game. And as we said, Coach DeCenzo does not like to put it up today. He is being forced to do that and adjust that offensive game plan because of the inability of Ben Bartone to take a snap from center.
Got a timeout on the field, and we got about a little bit over 30 seconds left to go here in the first quarter of play. Reminder that at the conclusion of the game, we'll be making our Thomas Dodge Player of the Game presentation. When we resume play here, it'll be a first down for the Raiders, the first time they have entered Shelton territory in football at the 46-yard line. Ben Bartone starting to find his receivers now. And look at the people up behind. That's behind our press box here at Ryan Field. This is a real huge crowd. I got to think, too, we've got a big assist from the weathermen that they have cooperated here, and you, not a lot of wind at all. As a matter of fact, no wind out there, and ideal conditions for late November. First down out of the shotgun. That's Enrollment out of the shotgun. 45, trying to get outside of contain, and Dave slides inside the 40-yard line before he's upended by Johnson on the far side of the field.
Derby has got to be able to do this. They've got to be able to balance that pass with some runs, and Enrollment and Potke have got to have some room with the passing game to get some running and some ground attack going, and that is a big play in that offense, and they've got to begin to force Shelton to think not only about that pass but the run. And it'll present some problems defensively for Shelton if Derby can continue to have this kind of success.
Bartone back on second down, has the protection, wings it out. Incomplete, a flag is dropped. Shepard was the intended receiver, Darby on the coverage. Let's see who the penalty is against. It might go against the defense.
That one's going against Derby.
Now it's going against Derby on the offense.
No question about it. Watch number 34, Shepard, as the ball is thrown. He is going to hit the Shelton receiver in the back. Watch him push off. He has already done it and then tries to get out away from Darby. Darby had great coverage. Shepard pushed him from behind, and that will be brought back. It will go against the Derby Red Raiders.
Remember, Darby early in this in the first quarter intercepted Bartone, and that interception led to Shelton's first score. Rob Darby, 6'1", 180-pound senior deep back for the Gales. Here's the indication by Dick Hildebrand.
It's a big one, too. It'll cost them 15 as it'll drive them back across midfield to their own 46-yard line. Bring up a second and almost 20 yards for the Derby football team as they need that distance for the first down.
I don't know if I misread that clock or not, but we are still in the first quarter of play. I thought we were under a minute. Now it's showing about 52 seconds. Second and long, second and 18, as a matter of fact, the football at the 46 of the Raiders. Bartone screens it, that is to Potke, but he overthrows Potke on the screen, and Shelton was ready for the play.
33, Potke, incomplete. Pretty good pressure inside by Shelton. Number 55 right up the middle, that's Ray Sawyer. Forces the ball to be thrown a little bit earlier than I think Ben Bartone wanted to. There was not enough distance between the lineman and the screen back, and they could not get a completion. It'll bring up a third again and a long distance, about 20 yards for that Derby offense.
Let's look at that clock together. Is that 47 seconds?
I think it's 41, but 47, right? It's tough to see with the sun. The sun is shining right on the scoreboard.
We both need a trip to the eye doctor. Age. Third and long. Bartone under a rush. Still with the football. Getting it out. No receiver in the area.
He's going to get a penalty here. We're going to get a late hit on Ben Bartone as he's going to be slow to get up. But as Bartone released the football, he got drilled from behind. And it's going to go as a roughing the passer. You'll watch Dickie Hildebrand with the signal. And if you've been following Larry Griffin all year, you'll know this one. It's a roughing call, and it will be a 15-yarder against Shelton. And Derby will have an opportunity to get another play as they'll get the third down over. Watch as Bartone rolls to this near side. As he gets rid of the football, he's going to get wailed in the back right in the midsection, right there, and we lose it, but he got drilled, unable to complete the pass, but it is a big play for the Derby offense as they will have a 3rd and 5 back where they got that interference penalty two plays ago.
That puts them back in business. And the football now at the 39-yard line after the mark off of the penalty, 39 of Shelton. Derby has the football. Shelton leads it in the first quarter as you get a look at head coach Tony Brink of Shelton. Shelton leads it 14-0. And now the Gales want to take a timeout. Gives me an opportunity to tell everyone that today's coverage of the high school football game of the week is a presentation of Cable 10 Sports, Telemedia of Western Connecticut. It is intended solely for the viewing enjoyment of Telemedia subscribers. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of Telemedia of Western Connecticut is prohibited.
See Charlie DeCenzo in the middle of his offensive huddle. They need a first down here. They really need a touchdown at some point before those Shelton Gales can get a hold of that football again. They've got to get in the end zone. They need a pep rally to get their kids back into this game. Shelton has jumped them early. 2 interceptions converted by the Gales. 2 points. In the middle there, you see one of the great coaches ever to coach anywhere in high school football, but he did it at Derby, and that's Coach DeCenzo, who has one of the best Coach DeCenzo. I'm talking
about Coach DeFilippo.
Apologize. Lou DeFilippo and his lovely wife there watching the game as they do at all Derby football games. A great football coach, a great football player in his days also.
It'll be a 3rd down for Derby coming up in this long, long first quarter here at Ryan Field in Derby with all the passing and all the incompletions. We've got a couple of scores, and that does make for a long period. 3rd and 4 at the 39 of Shelton. Out of the shotgun, 2 wideouts to the left side. Bartone looking short, has the time, floats it out there, and Darby, the defender, along with Lord, the intended receiver, goes as an incompleted pass. Darby has played that position well defensively.
Ball was very poorly thrown. Again, a rainbow from Bartone as he gets it out, but he just throws it up in the air. Really, if there was a wind, it might have got drifted into the bleachers, and Darby had a better chance of getting it than the intended receiver, Shepard. Brings up a 4th here now for the Red Raiders as they look as if they're going to go for it here on 4th and short.
Lord again with Shepard out to the left side. 4th and 4. Let's see if the Raiders go a little bit misdirection, run the football. Potke, he is going to be stopped well short of the yardage for the first down. Johnson, who has come up big from his linebacker spot, the Gales will take over on downs.
They just try and come again to the left side with Potke, and really, the Shelton Gales just did an excellent job of defensing it. 24 for the Gales, right in on a tackle, and that is Robbie Johnson, and they just closed that right off, and the Gales will take over right out about the 38-9 yard line, their own 38.
First down for Shelton, eye back formation. John Eason slides outside, 45 midfield, down to the Derby 45 for the first down for the Gales as Eason goes a-running. Mark Brito from his linebacker spot on the tackle for Derby.
Eason is scary if you're a defensive player and he gets into that secondary. He has that great speed. He gets down the field very well and does an excellent job of following his blockers as he's across midfield. And they're going to get an additional 15 tacked on as the Red Raiders are going to get a personal foul. And that will bring the football down close to the 30-yard line. So a great run by Eason, and the penalty tacked on to this will put the ball at the 31-yard line. The Derby Red Raider defense now is going to be challenged again as this first quarter will come to an end.
And that'll do it. We have played 1 quarter here at Ryan Field in Derby. Our score is Shelton 14, Derby nothing. We're back, everyone, set for the 2nd quarter of play here at Ryan Field in our Telemedia Sports Valley High School football game of the week, the Thanksgiving Day Classic between Derby and Shelton. This is the 81st renewal of this great, great series. First down for the Gales. after an Eason run and a personal foul against the Raiders as Bob Ayer tries to center at a line. The big fullback inside the 20-yard line. Hard to bring down. Coming up eventually from the pile, Joe Ferrigno, who's been a standout defensively for Derby thus far.
Watch Ayer just come on a little bit of a delay and then comes back behind his guards right up the middle for excellent yardage. He's going to pick up a first down. He's inside the 20-yard line.
Football at the 19. It's another first down for the Shelton Gaels. Running at will now against the Raiders. They got that big offensive line. They got two great backs, too, as we get flags dropped before the play begins.
Looks like the Shelton Gaels are going to be guilty of illegal procedure. It'll back them up five. Dickie Hildebrand making the signal, and it'll bring up a second or a first and 15 from about the 25. Shelton has been able to run the football. They have not thrown yet with a completion. Three attempts by Field. He has not completed one, but Eason and Ayer are certainly carrying the baggage in the backfield with the running attack. And again, that front is opening some big holes in that Derby defense.
First and 15. Eason to the center of the line and spins out of a couple of tackles and gets about three more yards on the play. Potke on the tackle for Derby. I thought Eason was stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Has good leg drive, almost broke away, as you just said, Eddie, from a couple of tackles. And if he gets in there, as we saw earlier when he went 42, he can go the distance. Outruns that tackle right there from number 43 and then just makes a few extra yards on his own as he is down around the 22-yard line. A big second down for the Gaels right here. And again, we can't overstate it. Derby cannot afford to allow Shelton in the end zone.
Second and 12 from the 22. Play action. Field looking to throw. Throws it out short. That's Eason on the reception. Down to the 10, 5, and touches down at about the 1-yard line. Marco Brito closest to Eason. Eason catching the pass out of the backfield.
Watch, Eason does not break stride. His field is going to get a lot of pressure from the backside, but he gets it off. Here's Eason, and watch, Eason never breaks stride. It's just dumped right in there. A great throw from the quarterback. Eason down inside the 5 to about the 2-yard line.
Two wideouts either side of the field, and you got to think they're going to just go through the center of the line, and the senior quarterback Field takes it in for the third Shelton score of the day. Dan Field, outstanding year for the 6'1", 180-pound senior quarterback.
Field will just put his head down, and he is into the end zone. And the Derby defense now has given up a quick 20 points as we are just beginning this second quarter. Not a good effort by that defense, but the offense has put them into trouble. They have given too many turnovers, and the Gaels have converted.
Oh, Paterny. His kick is wide of the mark as the teams come upfield. Shelton leads it 20-0.
Ball will go to the outside, to the right side. Again, Oh, Paterny with that one step, just trying to get the ball up. You see it missed to the right. But still, the Gaels enjoy a 20-0 lead just beginning this second quarter here at Ryan Field. And it has been all Shelton in this football game. They certainly have done what they wanted to do on offense and been able to stop the Red Raiders on defense. Shelton controlling the line of scrimmage offensively right across the front with Sylvester, Blanchett, Gaddis, Bobby, Darby, and D'Agostino. They have just
unbelievable.
Really opened some gaping holes in that Derby defense.
They are big, big young men. D'Agostino, I mentioned this before, D'Agostino, Sylvester, and Bobby especially, they have played 3 years across that front wall. Glenn Blanchett, that's been an interesting story at Shelton. There's a young man. He's been moved to a lot of different positions. Finally settles back at a position he played as a freshman. Offense, and that is at center. The kickoff by Oh, Paterny. And Ed McManus, one of the up men for the Raiders, takes the kickoff back to the 34-yard line. So let's see what the Raiders can do in the second quarter. And the Raiders are down by 3 scores. Raiders having two of their wide receivers both in at the same time because they've been basically going to a passing formation. In a passing offense, they know they have to throw under some pressure. Bartone gets it off, It is almost picked off right in front of us at the 40-yard line. Going for the reception was Shepard. On the coverage is Fetty along with Unfricked.
Eddie Bartone is not getting any time to set his feet, and therefore he's trying to throw the ball strictly with his arm. He cannot get the ball that distance down the field. As you see him running for his life here, throws a wobbly pass. It's really underthrown. Again, good coverage, but two Shelton people had a better opportunity than the intended receiver, Shepard, to get that football. Derby has got to provide some time for their quarterback, Ben Bartone, to set and throw the football if they're going to get some completions.
Once again, Shepard along with Lord out to the right side. A high snap from center out of the shotgun. Bartone wings it, completes it. It's now a dropped football. And let's see if they rule it a completion. They do, and the Shelton Gales have fallen on the loose football. Might have been Bobby Ayer who fell on the loose football. The pass was completed to Shepard. Ball was knocked out of his hands.
You're going to get a fumble recovery here as the ball is thrown to Shepard. Shepard will catch it. Then he will turn up the field, and the ball will be knocked or stripped out of his hand right there.
Johnson strips him of the football, and Ayer comes up with it right in front of the Turby bench.
Again, another turnover. Great field position for Shelton as they have the ball inside the 40 at about the 37-yard line.
And they are making it look easy. Field gives to Eason on a sprint draw action, and Eason has popped a couple of times there after he picks up a good yardage on first down. Ferrigno again on the stop for the Raiders.
There was no one at the line of scrimmage as Eason came across the line of scrimmage down the field. Watch Eason take the little bit of a sprint draw, air on the lead block. There's no one there, and then Ferrigno will get him about 4.5 to 5 yards down the field, but Eason able to get 4.5 to 5 before he runs into any red jerseys.
Eason picks up 6 on the first down carry. That's been a familiar story all day long here at Ryan Field. 2nd and 4. Eason bumps into his quarterback Field, but he still advances the football, still gets some positive yardage on the play.
Eddie, as we just saw a lot of the fans up behind us, they're going to go home for turkey very early if the Derby defense cannot do something. Again, the collision between Field and Eason. Eason still with the presence of mind to get forward and to pick up about 2 yards, making it 3rd and less than 3. Inside the 30 at about the 29-yard line. Again, Shelton just able to manhandle that Derby defense along the front.
3rd and 1 inside the 30. A draw again. Eason, this time he is hemmed in and stopped at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a loss on the play. The middle of that Derby defense is equal to the task. Marco Brito got his helmet in there, and also coming in from the secondary, the sophomore Mike Potke. The Raiders stopped the Gales on 3rd and short.
Trying to pull there, you saw number 65, Sylvester, trying to get his back in behind him, but Derby closed it right off. They were coming on a stunt that time and closed it down. It's about the same distance, 4th and about 3.
And Dan Field decides to talk things over on the Shelton side of the field. We've got a break in the action in the second quarter, and our score is Shelton 20 and Derby nothing. Welcome back, everyone. Shelton has a 4th and 2 from the 29 of the Raiders, and they have a 20-0 lead. Second quarter action. Field, play action, eludes a tackle, gets it off, it is intercepted. Shepard on the interception, and Shepard out to the 27, and the Raiders are back in business as they stop a Shelton drive.
Ball was very poorly thrown by Danny Field as he's going to roll to the near side. On this 4th down, he is forced out of the pocket and then cannot set his feet, throws the ball, and then Shepard with the interception. He will bring the ball back close to the 30-yard line. Shelton player is down, and we will wait to see who it is. Ben Bartone will try and get that offense going.
Unfricked was the intended receiver for the Gales on that 4th down play.
Looks like number 65, but we'll wait to see. And that's Leon Sylvester. Coach Branke and his staff are out there with him at this point.
Leon, of course, one of the 5 captains for Coach Tony Branke for the 1991 season. A lot of good leadership for the Gales, the captains, Nedavaska, Dan Chavs, Sylvester, D'Agostin, and the quarterback, Dan Field. Excellent senior leadership. As you see, Coach DeCenzo satisfied that everything is in order out there on the field. And it was, in fact, it is Leon Sylvester.
He's a big guy when he gets up, huh?
He's had some problems, buddy, physically with his legs there, and remains to see whether he'll get back. He's a gamer. He'd like to get back into this football game, his last game, possibly for the Gales. I say that possibly because Gales having an outside chance of making the Class L sweepstakes in the state playoffs. But there's an awful lot of ifs. First down for the Raiders out of the shotgun.
Again.
Movement both sides of the ball. The ball is not snapped and will await the official's call.
When you move to the shotgun, it presents a change in cadence and it's a little bit different. And the offense has not yet really adjusted to that as they have had their second mistake on that cadence with the snap. Watch the number of people that are off sides here on this. The ball just does not come. Everybody moves, especially that right side. They were all in motion. Didn't get it off, and it puts Derby back another five, and they can ill afford to be first and 15 at this point of the football game.
They're at their 21-yard line. We're in the second quarter here at Ryan. High snap from center again. Barton pulls it down, has a receiver out there. It is caught by Shepard. Shepard's been open, and Shepard is shy of the yardage for the first down, out to the 34. Johnson on the coverage and on the tackle for Shelton.
This is the 15th pass of this first half. Barton, again, when he has time to step up and throw, is very accurate. He has 7 completions for 15 attempts. They are, again, close to that first down yardage, but the secret is going to be the ability to protect Barton and to give him time to throw. When he's forced out of that pocket and he has to throw on the run, he is unable to get that arm in the distance necessary to get those completions.
Second and 2 for the Raiders. Another high snap, and he hands off. That is Enroman, Dave Enroman, the ball carrier. He, again, is shy of the yardage for the first down. The football will be marked at about the 35, and Derby has to get it to the 36. Croc on the tackle for Shelton.
See the high snap, and that causes a problem in the rhythm necessary for the handoff. There's a little collision between Barton and Enroman. Short of the first down yardage, it'll bring up a big third down here for Derby. They need, again, a drive. It is 5:33 left to go in this first half, and they really have done very little offensively to challenge that Shelton defense.
Lord Shepard out to the left side. Inside handoff, Potgay, and Potgay has picked up the first down as John gets it out to the 40-yard line.
Barton got drilled again. The flag went up from Dickie Hilderman. I think you're going to see another personal foul against the Shelton Gales as they hit Barton as he released the handoff to Potkay. There was an awful lot of penetration along that Derby offensive line. The Shelton Gales are in very quickly on the quarterback. You see the signal, again, personal foul. The ball again high, Potkay gets it, and then boom, number 88, Dan Chives. He drilled the quarterback, Ben Barton. Again, he will get that personal foul. It'll put the ball down at the 45-yard line. 5:19 left to go in this first half. The Derby Red Raiders need a score. They've got to get into that end zone. They've got to take something positive in at the end of this first half.
Ferrigno, the tight end, to the left side. Shepard, Lord out to the right side, out of the shotgun. Derby's going exclusively shotgun. The short pass that is open, dropped by Shepard. Had it in his stomach and dropped it at the 37.
Well thrown ball by quarterback Ben Barton. Shepard does not look it in. Hits him right in the chest and just bounces away. Tight spiral, hit him in the numbers. Did not look it in, and it'll bring up a second down.
Second down coming up for Derby in the second quarter here at Ryan Field. The conditions excellent for Thanksgiving Day, and the crowd is huge.
Good day to get out and hit the golf ball. What a day, Edward.
Maybe for you. Second down. Barton unleashes it downfield. It is almost picked off. Drop there. Rob Johnson on the coverage. Shepard was the intended receiver, and Johnson almost came up with Shelton's third interception.
Again, Barton sitting in the pocket, has pretty good protection, throws the ball down the field. Shepard unable to cut inside of Johnson. Johnson just does not hold on to it at the 10-yard line. It'll bring up a 3rd and 10 for Derby. That was the 17th attempt by the Derby Raiders at throwing the football. Barton has completed 7 of those 17.
Third down coming up. Football at the 45-yard line. We've got a little bit under 5 minutes to go here in the first half of play at Ryan Field. Shelton is the Housatonic League champions. They earned that by their win over Cheshire a couple weeks ago. Screen over the middle. Dave and Roman on the reception out of the backfield. Bob Ayer on the coverage and on the tackle. It'll be coming. It'll be a 4th down and about 5 for the Raiders.
Derby allows the Shelton offensive line or defensive line to come across. Then they just try and throw the ball to Enrollman. Linebackers, you see Ayer coming up there. Linebackers did a good job of stepping up and preventing any big play as Ansel and Ayer did a good job on coverage. It'll bring up, as Eddie said, that 4th and about 5 here inside the 40-yard line. Derby not thinking at all about punting the football at this point in the game.
They need to score, and they need it just about now. Barton shifts back into that punt formation, trying to draw Shelton offside.
And this may cause them to rethink and to possibly kick the football as we see the Derby team now bringing their special teams unit out to try and put Shelton back at their own goal line. But they tried to draw the penalty as they shifted out of that first time, out of that setback position with the quarterback behind the center. If they might have been using that a little bit more, they might have been able to draw Shelton off. The fact that Shelton has seen the shotgun did not fool them, and the Red Raiders are going to have to punt the football.
Sophomore Mike Potke will be kicking the football away, standing at his 42-yard line. Back deep is Peterson for Shelton. And Potke, a high, short punt. And down by the Raiders at the 28-yard line.
That's going to be a net gain of under 10 yards, so it didn't work out very well for the Red Raiders. As in this first half, nothing really has gone well for them, and a lot has had to do with the fact that the Shelton Gales are just playing great football, both offensively and defensively here in this game.
Gales have spread their scoring around. Eason, 42-yard gallop in the first quarter. Bobby Ayer took it in later in the first quarter, 4 yards out. Field in the second quarter on a quarterback sneak from 1 yard out. Eason making the moves and going up the middle. Dragged down by Marco Brito, the linebacker, after a pickup of 2 on the play out to the 30.
Del Muro is going to get credit also as the backside bolt guard and tackle as Bobby and Gaddis try and get a hole for Eason. Closed it down pretty well, the Derby Red Raiders did, as we are under 3 minutes here to go in this first half. It's been all Shelton in this first half of football.
Football just outside the 30-yard line, and we're under 3 minutes to go in the first half. And our Telemedia Sports Valley High School football game of the week. Always a special occasion, Thanksgiving, to pass out to Darby, incomplete. And Don Buono had a lot to do with it. The safety got a hand in there and prevented the completion.
This is textbook coverage by Buono as he just will stick his arm. As you see Field throw the football, watch Buono come in with his arm right in front of Darby. A great job on coverage. Brings up a 3rd down for the Gales as they have, for the first time, been stymied by that Derby defense in this football game, other than the opening drive.
3rd and 7 at the 30. Play action. Field scanning the field, gets it out. It is caught by Croc in traffic. Steve Croc for Shelton. 1st down out to the 46-yard line. The tight end upended there by Brito.
Only the 2nd completion from Danny Field, but it's a big one as he hits Croc, his tight end coming across on the bootleg. He will get outside. He does a good job in hitting number 19 for the 1st down yardage at about the 46-yard line. Another 1st down for the Gales as they have been able to convert with the running and passing when necessary in this first half.
Derby is doing an awful lot of substitutions, making a lot of substitutions defensively, playing a lot of young players out there too. John Eason on the 1st down carry out to the, or into Derby territory down to the 49. Angelo DeRuba is one of those young players in at linebacker. He made the stop of Eason.
Air will kick out, and look at Air. He finds no one to block until he's 5 yards down the field. That's because that offensive line is just opening some gaping holes in that right and left tackle spot. Eason picks up another 6 yards.
Second and four for Shelton at the 49. Eason rolling, looking to throw, completes it to a wide open receiver. That is Unfrick on the reception. Unfrick takes the football down to the 40-yard line. DeMorrow upends him at that point. DeMorrow, the nose guard.
Field rolls to the outside. He will get outside of contain. You see the defensive end there just unable to get him. And then he throws back, finds an open man, picks up good yardage for another first down as the Gales moving here with about 1:20 left to go in this first half.
First down for the Gales. Eason gets away from a couple of tackles and slides off the right side. DeMorrow on the stop for the Raiders. Would you call Eason elusive?
Watch him sidestep number 65, Jimmy Gregorio, the senior, and then just step into the secondary for some little bit of a game. But he is very elusive and a very, very difficult guy. If you don't break down and tackle, he is going to leave you grabbing for air, as he is a great, great running back. And again, he'll be back next year.
That entire backfield, with the exception of quarterbacks, going to be back, and the backups are going to be back too. On the fly pattern on second down, the pass intended for Peterson goes incomplete on the far sidelines. Shepard on the coverage for the Raiders.
Field tries to go to Peterson on the out and up route. Pretty good coverage, but it is overthrown as Danny Field throws a beautiful pass, but overthrown. Shepard on coverage. Peterson just couldn't get to it. It's a third down and 9 for the Gales.
Buddy, a big part of the Shelton success story, no question about it, the emergence of Dan Field as a quarterback this year. And that pass and the threat of the pass in the Shelton offense. Eason stopped. First to get to him, DeRosa, along with Ken Lyman, both around the football for Derby.
DeRosa will come on a stunt. They try and run the draw, and Eason is just going to get corralled before he really has an opportunity to go anywhere. And that's a big play, as it'll bring a fourth down as we wind down here with about 17 seconds left to go in this first half. Shelton does really doesn't have to snap the football and kick it, as we probably will run the half out here for the Derby Red Raiders down as they go on a fake. I love it.
Fetty throws out a punt formation. It is intercepted on the far sidelines. Was that Lord who made the interception? Rich Lord, the deep back on the interception, and it's Derby's football with one tick left.
This is the third interception by the Red Raiders as the ball is thrown out on the attempted fake. Good coverage by Derby, and they will pick off their third pass of this football game. We have 1 second left to go in this first half.
What's your call, Coach?
My call, take a knee and get in and start making some adjustments.
Well, he's going to have to kneel down from shotgun because that's where he is. First down. Over the middle as the flag is dropped. That is Enrollman. And Roman trying to get some running room. It's popped out of his hands. It's knocked out by one of the Gales, Johnson. And now let's wait for the officials to unravel the play. As
it's going to be a holding.
No time.
It's going to be a holding penalty. Shelton should refuse it. There should not be another play. We will go in, and everyone will enjoy a halftime here. We'll see how right I am on this one. It's a defensive or offensive mistake. You can end the game right here if you want, or Derby can force them back, or Shelton can force them back. The way the Gales are going, they're going right into the locker room.
You're right.
Got to be right once. I've been wrong so many. The odds were with me on this one.
We played one half of football here at Ryan Field in Derby on the annual Thanksgiving Day, the 81st renewal between these two fine high schools. Our score is Shelton 20 and Derby nothing. We'll be back with our halftime activities right after these messages. Welcome back, everyone. Halftime activities here at Ryan Field in Derby. And entertaining for us right now, Derby girls out there And we'll be followed by the Shelton High School marching band. Once again, our halftime score is Shelton 20 and Derby nothing. Enjoy our halftime presentation. Thank you.
will be in the Gale Fort. The band and color guard will perform to the Pismo.
Thank you.
color guard is featured to Mag 7. Stuff to Alexander's Ragtime Band. Return to Cam Cam. Thank you. finale, the band and color guard march a maneuver to Regencia.
Was the Shelton High School marching band after the Derby pom-pom girls entertaining here at halftime at Ryan Field in Derby. Our halftime score is Shelton 20 and Derby nothing. We want to tell our subscribers and our viewers that we will be replaying the entire football season. That's right, the entire football season between December the 15th and January the 6th. And we're going to be showing that schedule to you right now. The games, all of our games of our 1991 scholastic football season. This is done as a public service by Telemedia Cable 10, so subscribers will have an opportunity to tape games. And we'll be right back with our second half kickoff right after these messages. We're back, everyone. We're moments away from the second half kickoff here at Ryan Field in Derby. And the Shelton Gales lead it by a score of 20-0, scoring twice in the first quarter and once in the second quarter. First two scores by Shelton as a result of Derby turnovers, and Shelton converting on those first two turnovers by the Derby Red Raiders. Derby has turned our football over a few more times, as have the Shelton Gales, but I think very early in that football game, buddy, those two turnovers and the fact that Shelton converted so early, critical in this football game.
They really were. The Derby interception set Eason up for a 42-yard run at 7:37 of that first quarter, and then Fetty with an interception allowed Ayers the opportunity to run 4 yards. The Shelton Gales jumped off to an early 14-0 lead in that first quarter, and they haven't really looked back. The Derby Red Raiders have been unable to get their offense moving. At the end of that first half, Jim Gregorio, number 65 for Derby, was ejected from the football game. He will not participate in the second half. We are unsure as to the reason. It had to do with that last penalty that you saw at the end of the first half, and he will not participate, and that may be a loss. The Derby Red Raiders, defensively especially, Gregorio, the senior, 5'11", 180-pounder, will be unable to participate in that defense or with that defensive group as the Gales are ready to get this kickoff.
Brito's kickoff, line drives it, kicks it inside the 10. He drives Eason back at that point. Eason to the 25, and he has stopped there.
Talking at halftime, an interesting statistic, Edward, is that the Derby or that the Shelton offensive group has scored 5 times when they have taken the kickoff in the second half on their opening drive, and twice they have gone within the first or second play. So it'll be interesting to see whether the Gales can continue that tradition and just take the football and move it down the field for another score.
Football is at the 25, the first play from scrimmage in the second half. Gales in control of the football game. Eason breaks free temporarily. He gets the first down, tackled by defensive end John Potke along with Dave and Roman. And it is a Shelton first down.
Eason just comes right up the middle, follows Ayers fullback. He almost breaks through as you see him get in and then finally dragged to the ground along with Enrollman and company. But very close and does get that first down at about the 36-yard line.
He is just such an explosive runner. You could stop him 4 or 5 times, and then, boom, he just breaks it. Eason in motion on first down. They give to the fullback. Maybe Coach Branca wants to use a lot of clock in the second half as the junior fullback gets 2 yards on the first down carry. Center of that Derby defense in on the play, led by Ferrigno, the linebacker. Ferrigno's been in on a lot of tackles for the Raiders. Second down and 8 for the Gales, just underway. Beautiful Ryan Field in Derby. In this Thanksgiving Day Classic, the 81st renewal between Shelton Derby. I-back formation. They give to Eason on a little bit of sprint draw. John Potke, along with Ferrigno, on the stop for the Raiders. Well, Derby has the ball offensively, buddy. Coach DeCenzo is going to have to insert someone at left guard, and that's where Jim Gregorio's played and started this football game. So we'll wait for the Raiders to get the football to see who they insert at that position.
Run the sprint draw, pretty good contact inside by the Derby middle linebacker. Brings up a big third down for Shelton.
Field rolling, throwing, and it's picked off. That's Rich Lord in front of us. Rich Lord, the deep back for the Raiders, takes the football down to the 42-yard line.
That is something that the Gales did not want to do. They turn the ball over in excellent field position for Derby. They come on the bootleg. Field just tries to roll to this near side and then throws a very, very poorly thrown pass right into the hands of, I think, Rich Lord. Lord takes the ball down inside the 45 to about the 43-yard line. Excellent field position. And if the Red Raiders are going to get back in it, this is the point of the game where they've got to do it. Great field position. We'll see what they do with their opening possession.
Shotgun, first down. Bartone looks left, throws left, completes it on first down. And that's Shepard. Shepard's been a favorite target of Bartone. Shepard is now down on the turf, far side of the field.
just the turnout, and you see Bartone again having time to set his feet, hit Shepard right at about the first down marker. Shepard cannot pull free, but it is very close to the first down, and we'll see here whether they mark the first or the second. It's going to be second and very short for the Gales as coming out of the ball game is Shepard after that catch. A little bit shaken up, he'll come to the sidelines, probably be back within the next play.
Football now at the 34-yard line. Raiders looking to get on track offensively and doing it quickly. They like to do it quickly here in the third quarter. Shelton leads it 20-0. On our Telemedia Sports Valley High School football game of the week. Mike Massey now in at wideout for the Raiders out to the right side. Lord in a slot to the right. Out of shotgun, second and short. Bartone with good time to throw as a receiver out there. Overthrows Lord, who turned a couple of ways. On the coverage was Bob Ayer, step for step with Lord.
Did you get a response to the first ticket? It was our second ticket on the senior class.
Bartone rolls to the near side, and then he will overthrow Rich Lord. Again, Ayer, as Eddie said, right on the coverage, out of the reach of the intended receiver, number 81, Rich Lord. It'll bring up a third and very short for Derby, as they need the first down to keep the possession and the drive alive.
Third and short, out of the shotgun. Patke for the first down, knocking down Shelton defenders. John Patke for a Derby first down.
Good run inside by Patke as he just takes the handoff from Bartone and then will come right up the middle. Breaks a little bit to the far side and then does it all on his own as he gets down inside the 30 to about the 25-yard line. Big first down for Derby as they are knocking at the door for the first time in this football game as we enter the third quarter. They need a score and to get a pep rally going and to get that defense alive.
Bartone on a quick pass on a square out. That Shepard tries to bounce away from a tackle. Finally taken down, but it's a good pickup on first down. Bartone going into the short pass.
Derby has had excellent success with Bartone throwing short. They've gotten into trouble when he has tried to go deep. Turnout route again by Shepard. That's the route that they've been running all morning here. Shepard picks up about 8.5 yards again as he is close to that first down marker at the 15. He's tackled it around the 17. Second and short again. Derby with a free play here as they want to try and get the ball into the end zone. Ben Bartone in that shotgun where he's been all morning.
Second and short at the 17-yard line. High snap from center. Ben finally picks it up, but he's going to be taken down. Nedovaska, Jason, the nose guard, 5'7", 200-pound senior captain.
One of the keys is that Nedovaska is playing right over the center, and that snap has been a problem for Bartone all morning. The quarterback and center exchange. This time, Nedovaska beat the center right around them. A 5 yards, about a 10-yard loss. It'll bring up a third and 15, and that can take some of the momentum out of this drive that the Derby Red Raiders have going here in this third quarter.
Buddy, and our spotters have picked up the fact that playing left guard is Jimmy Gregorio, number 65 for the Raiders. At least there's a 65 in the football game. Bartone over the middle, a little bit of bumping over the middle. Shepard, the intended receiver. It was Johnson and Darby on the double coverage for the Gales. Goes as an incompleted pass, and Ben Bartone is on the turf again.
Bartone is going to get hit again as he releases the football. The ball is thrown down the middle, and you'll see some kind. You missed the contact on Shepard. Was not called, and it'll bring up a fourth down here as Ben Bartone is on the ground right at the 41-yard line. You see the coaching staff along with the training staff there with Bartone. He has not moved since he was knocked to the ground. Head coach Forrest Shelton is out there also along with their training staff as Coach Branca and Coach DiCenzo, along with the rest of the Derby team right now, are waiting to see about Ben Bartone.
Buddy, we have a break in the action. Our score is Shelton 20 and Derby nothing.
Yeah.
We're back, everyone. There is Ben Bartone. He's being assisted over to the Derby bench. I've got to give Ben Bartone a lot of credit, buddy, for coming back with that broken arm. Suffered against North Haven early in the season, missed a few games in the middle of the Derby season, and coming back for the last three games of the season, a tremendous amount of credit to that young man, because definitely not playing at 100%, doing everything he can do for the Derby Red Raider cause. Dominic Buono now in at quarterback. It's a fourth down for the Raiders after the incomplete pass, fourth and 15. The football at the 30. Dominic rolling to the left under a rush, and he's going to be taken down. That is Piscinari, number 78, Jeff Piscinari, 6'1", 210-pound junior tackle.
Defensively, the Gales have risen to the occasion. As Buono tries to come on the bootleg, he will get run down right there. You see number 78 corral him, and then he is going to get popped right there from number 19, Croc. It is a turnover. The possession will change, and the Shelton Gales now will start out at their own 37-yard line. The Derby football team offensively could not keep that drive going. Losing Bartone on third down there has to make a difference. The sack on the exchange between quarterback and center was the big play of that drive.
John Eason. Eason outside to the midfield, 40. Tries to reverse his field, now cuts it back up the sidelines again inside the 35 before he's taken down by Patke and Ferrigno. John Eason, what explosiveness.
Watch as he gets to the outside and then just puts it into gear. He will get into overdrive as he gets around this end. Nobody touches him as he breaks to the outside, and then it becomes a foot race. And Roman does a good job of taking the outside lane and closing it off, preventing Eason from getting to the sideline, and then Derby finally corrals him, but not before Eason is down inside the 40 to about the 33.
Air inside the big bruising fullback, but he's tied up inside by the Raiders. See who gets up off the stack for the Raiders. Number 54 now in at the linebacker, sophomore Adam Saylor, one of the Derby tacklers. Also in around the football, Angela Daruba. So the Raiders now with two sophomores right in the middle of that defense at linebacker. Be a second down for Shelton, second and 8. The football resting at the Derby 30-yard line. Pitch to Eason. Eason bounces it outside, 20. Inside the 20-yard line, Adam Saylor finally on the tackle for the Raiders, but another Gale first down, and Eason is running at will.
Watch number 44, Bobby Ayer, make a great block for Eason, and Eason just runs up the back of number 44 and then just breaks. See that block? See, took number 41 for Derby to the dirt. Allows Eason to get in there. That was Potke who was knocked to the ground, and Eason just follows Ayer for big yardage. They've got another first down inside the 20.
Football at the 17. First down for the Gales. Split backs. They give it to Eason. Eason winding his way through the middle. Inside the 15, close to the 10. Leo Winner on the stop from his defensive end spot for the Raiders.
Eason just follows again the offensive line surge as he comes up inside the right and left tackle there. Blanchett, Gaddison, Bobby, that right side for good yardage. He picks up a 5. About 5 as he's down close to that 10-yard line.
Second and 5 for the Gales. Eason in motion. Tied up inside. That is Ayer. Saylor first to get to him. Also around the football, Winner.
Motion by Eason as you see him come into the picture, and then Ayer just back up inside for tough yardage as he is short of that first down. It'll bring up a third and about 3 for the Gales as they are definitely in that four down area. Looking for one more here to really put it out of reach for the Red Raiders.
Third and short for Shelton, split backs. They try Eason. Eason is stopped right at the line of scrimmage.
Eason is going to meet a pile as he tries to go forward. Follows Ayer inside, but a lot of red jerseys right on the tackle. 41 in there early. Potke and company It'll bring up a fourth down, and it looks like a field goal.
It'll be O'Patterney attempting the field goal to extend the Shelton lead. It will be short, wide to the right side, so Derby will take over on their 20-yard line.
The Gales are allowing the Derby Red Raiders to hang around here as they couldn't put that one away.
Let's go to our third quarter feature now. Coach's tips, and Buddy will be talking about jumping rope.
Today we like to talk a little bit about quickness. Quickness is very important for an athlete. There's speed and then what coaches like to call quickness. There's a difference. Quickness comes with the ability to be able to move your feet and to be able to react quickly. We have a very simple drill that we use every day for our quarterbacks and our skilled people, and it's just the use of a rope. And what we do, as Bobby is going to show you here, is just jump it. It's an old, simple exercise, but it's one that builds quickness, it builds agility, and it also builds cardiovascular endurance. If you're going to work, be an athlete, you need that cardiovascular improvement. Get a rope, whether you're young or old, 2 to 4 minutes every day, and just jump it. It'll build that quickness, it'll improve your speed, and you're going to become a better athlete. Work at it. And this is the last tip for the year, so we'll see you again next year.
We're back, everyone. Third quarter action, late third quarter action. On the missed field goal try, Derby takes over on the 20. Bartone is in again for the Raiders. A gallant performance. Shepherd, the intended receiver, incomplete. Fetty along with Unfrick on the coverage.
Double coverage as Bartone just tries to get a long one here to Shepherd. Double coverage, never an opportunity to complete it as he gets the ball down the field. But again, throwing into double coverage, the Gales are not going to give up a big home run here at this point in the football game, as their secondary has done a real outstanding job of keeping that big play out of their Derby offense.
Dave Van Roman tied up Ray Sawyer from his nose guard spot.
Sawyer was right in the middle of that handoff. As you see the handoff to Van Roman, look at 55 and then 52. Sawyer, and he got help for number 52 there for the Gales in making that stop. And about a 5-yard loss for the Derby offense as the running attack, a big part of that Derby football team the last couple of years, has just been unable to get going because of that shotgun and the really that fine rush from the Shelton Gale defense.
They're down third and long for Derby. Bartone under a rush, now running the football across the line of scrimmage, and he gets out of bounds on the near sidelines. Running him out there, Sawyer, along with Toby Valco.
Valco and Sawyer, watch, someone is coming free all the time. You see 73 come right now. He is really untouched. He forces Bartone out of the pocket. The Gales have had someone in the backfield all the time putting pressure on Ben Bartone. He is forced to run for his life. He gets the ball up the field for about 5, but they're going to force the Derby football team to punt.
And Tony Branca already making liberal substitutions on the defense. As Potke punts it away, it'll take a Derby roll. He'll roll dead at about the 39-yard line of Shelton, where the Gales will take over again. Shelton leads it by a score of 20-0, firmly in control of this football game.
0-0-3-5-7-5. You have that number, report to press booth. That's on 50-50.
Once again, a reminder that at the conclusion of the game, we'll be making our Thomas Dodge Player of the Game presentation. And let's see if Coach Branca starts substituting on that offensive line and in general throughout that offense. Right now, that is the first unit. He started to substitute already defensively. Eason, midfield, 45, goodbye, 30. John Eason.
Number 20, John Eason.
61-yard touchdown run from scrimmage. Once he breaks that line of scrimmage and he gets an opening, he is gone.
This is just straight ahead, and Eason just puts it into overdrive as he hits the linebacker area, and he just gets a little pull there, and it's bye-bye as he is going to just outrun the secondary into the end zone. That's Mike Massey, number 17. But he has got some outstanding breakaway speed, and he does it again.
And O'Patterney's kick just over the crossbar. It counts. And the Gaels lead it 27-0 late in the third quarter.
An awful lot of happy black and gold and some very disappointed red and white. Eason will take the handoff from field. He will follow Bobby Ayers into the line, and then he just breaks it right here. An arm tackle there. He outruns from number 74. He couldn't get him, and then it's just all John Eason down the center of the field. And Roman Massey on the chase. And Roman leaves them, or Eason leaves them in behind him as he goes across the goal line for the 26th and the conversion 27th point of this football game. The Derby Red Raiders unable to stop the Shelton Gaels, and their offense for Derby unable to put any points on the board. That's been the story here this morning in this 81st traditional Thanksgiving rivalry between the Gaels and the Raiders.
A short kick by O'Patterney and a loose ball. That is a free ball. I think he just mishit the football. Ed McManus falls on the football for the Raiders at the 41-yard line, and that's where the Raiders will go on the offense.
Ball spurts out of this now. It looks like it's going to be covered here, and then it's going to come loose. Derby will recover at their own 41-yard line. But again, and Bill Pucci said it best, Murphy's Law has prevailed here for the Red Raiders. Anything that can go wrong will go wrong. And right now, it's going wrong because the Gaels have been the problem for the Derby football team.
Bartone throwing to Enrollman. Enrollman makes the catch close to midfield, and he pays a penalty for it. Rob Johnson, who's been outstanding defensively, puts a big hit on Enrollman.
The end in the top of the picture, number 82, comes clean again. This time Bartone is able to get the ball off to Enrollman for about 8 yards, but Derby has just not been able to solve the problem of that Shelton defense. They have not been able to protect Bartone. Someone in white has been coming clean across that line of scrimmage into the backfield on every snap.
A lot of white jerseys and clean jerseys across that front five defensively for Coach Tony Branca's team. As a Bartone gets the pass out, it's caught there by Massey. Let's see if it's ruled a completion, then a fumble recovery by Shelton. It is. Massey caught the pass. It was a first down, but the Gaels have come up with the loose football.
Again, it looks like the catch by Massey, the fumble will be caused, I think, by Darby, number 43. Bartone, good time as he sets, throws the strike outside to Massey. As Massey turns to go up the field, he is going to get drilled right there by Darby. Darby will cause the ball to come loose. You see it. It looks like Croc, number 19, will get to it for the recovery. The Shelton Gaels offensively back in business.
First down, Eason going to the races again. John Eason on first down, close to midfield. Brito from his linebacker spot on the tackle for the Raiders. As we wind things down here in the third quarter, Brito along with Massey on the play.
Eason for another first down, or close to it, as he just comes up the middle. Good yardage as he picks up 10 and a half yards for the first down. And when you got a horse, you might as well ride him. And boy, the Shelton Gaels have a horse in John Eason.
Unfrick to the bottom of your screen on first down. Eason running behind that big line, wants to bounce it outside, unable to do so because Ferrigno takes him down at that point. Joe Ferrigno, outstanding player for the Raiders in his career and in his final game as a Derby Red Raider. 6 foot, 190 pounds senior linebacker. And we have concluded matters here in the third quarter. Our third quarter score from Ryan Field and Derby is Shelton 27 and Derby nothing. We're back, everyone, set for the fourth quarter of action, and it's been total Shelton domination. They have just done the job all morning long here at Ryan Field. We've got Eason right now for unofficially 218 yards in that area. Rob Johnson on the carry, now in the backfield
Johnson
for the Gales. Sailor on the stop for the Raiders.
Johnson tries to come over that left side. Air leads for him, Johnson picks up about 2 yards on that carry.
So it'll be a third down coming up, third and eight, the football resting at the Derby 49-yard line. Peterson out to the right side, split backs for Shelton, third and long. Give it to the second back, that's Bob Ayer. Ayer slices off the left side, upended at the 46 by Ferrigno.
Ayer will come on a little bit of a misdirection. They crossbuck fake inside, and then Ayer tries to come back. Picked up about 3, not enough for the first down. Shelton is going to be in an unfamiliar position here. They're going to have to punt the football.
But do you get the feeling Shelton would like to play another game this year? That's Fetty's kick. It's going to sail just into the end zone. It will be ruled a touchback. Almost died at the 1 yard line. So Fetty's punt into the end zone. Derby will have it at their 20.
There's a penalty marker we'll see here as the ball bounces at the 10 and then will just roll into the end zone as you see the Red Raiders, Shepherd there, allowing the ball to go in. It'll go into the end zone and it will be brought back to the 20, but there is a penalty and we will see here as they are bringing the ball back. The flags and the down markers will move, so it'll be interesting to see how they spot this one. As they are talking, you see Dickie Hildebrand over there now trying to figure out the penalty and the yardage and the spot from which the yardage will be marked. It's going to go against Derby, and it's going to be a first down again. Murphy's Law, the Derby Red Raiders have just had a terrible morning here against the Shelton offense and defense. As Shelton now will get the first down. And some of the people are getting an early start on the turkey dinner, especially those wearing red and white, as it has not been a positive day for the Derby Red Raider fans and the Derby Red Raider football team.
Football now at the 39-yard line of Derby. First down for the Gales. So you got to think it's going to knock a lot of clock off. There's a flag down right in the center. That's going to be a hold, chances are, against the Gales as Eason took it straight through the center of the line.
Eason just follows his fullback as he has done most of the morning. You see Bobby Ayer on the lead block. Eason just picks his way through that offensive line into that secondary. He has been following his fullback and then making some outstanding cuts, obviously with 218 yards. He's done something right all morning. But Bobby Ayer and that offensive line have just sprung the holes that have allowed Eason the yardage that he has gotten. As you see the penalty being marked off, it'll be a hold. It'll be a first and 20 now for the Shelton Gales.
Once again, that offensive line, buddy, left tackle D'Agostino, the left guard Sylvester, and by the way, Leon entered this football game at the start of the third quarter. He was injured in that first half. Glenn Blanchett, the center, Guidus, the right guard, Dennis Bobby, the right tackle, and Darby and Croc alternated at the tight end. Field running the football down to the 40-yard line, taken down inside the 40 by Lord coming up from the secondary.
Looks like a snowstorm of yellow flags here, as there's going to be a penalty right at the 43. It'll go against Shelton on that run as Field just tries to bootleg to the near side. He makes the fake, and then he'll just put the ball down and come to the outside. We'll see if we can pick up the penalty. Field brought the ball down inside the 35. You see the flags behind him and tackled, but it'll be brought back on a blocking below the waist. As you see Dickie Hildebrand signal the blocking below the waist, and the Shelton Gales now will be backed up another 10, so they will be about 25 yards away from a first down inside their own territory at about their own 47-yard line.
First and long then, and the football, buddy mentioned, at the 47 of Shelton. Fourth quarter action, Telemedia Sports, a Valley High School football game of the week. Shelton firmly in control of this football game, 27-0. A little bit of misdirection again. That is Bob Ayer, the Derby defense. Read the play beautifully. Around the football was Leo Winner.
Air will go away from the fake to Eason on the cross buck. Not a lot of yardage, but he has been getting that tough inside yardage as the Derby Red Raiders have taken a timeout and the Shelton Gales have substituted their entire offensive unit at this point in the football game.
Let's give credit on that last tackle also to defensive tackle and senior Carlos Ortiz, along with Winner on the tackle. So Coach Brinka, wholesale substitutions, a whole different team in there on offense, realizing that this game is over.
And Eddie, I tell you, the games that we have done, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, this is the earliest that I have ever seen an entire unit substituted in this Derby Shelton football game. And Coach Branker realizes that his young men have played an outstanding game, and he is going to give some of the young people a chance to play in this very, very big and traditional game as he has sent an entirely new offensive unit into the game.
Well, the center is a younger brother of Glenn Blanchett. Jeff Blanchett is now the center, and second and long for the Gales at the 47 in fourth quarter action. Straight handoff into the center of the line on second down.
Ball carrier number 35.
Ball carrier is Jim Panagiotidis.
Panagiotidis takes the handoff again, following the fullback straight ahead. Doesn't get the big yardage, but right now the Gales just want to hold on, let the clock run, and go home and enjoy some turkey Thanksgiving dinner, because they have deserved it here this morning here at Ryan Field.
Steve Miller is the new quarterback, and the fullback is Rich, and Rich gets the carry on third down for a pair into Derby territory, and that's going to just about do it on that play. Winner on the tackle for the Raiders. It'll be a fourth down in a kicking situation for the Gales.
Fourth and long.
Back deep for the Raiders.
There's a new punting unit also in there for Shelton. I'm surprised Coach didn't put his first group back into punt, because special teams are an adventure, and you can see that right away they're having trouble lining up, but you don't want to get a turnover here.
Oh, that is Fetty, though, the regular punter, kicking it away. That's Dave Bizzotto on the other end. Bizzotto is taken down immediately by Jeff Batchko.
We're going to kick this one over, as there's a penalty on coverage. Did not allow the receiver an opportunity to catch, and the Derby punting, or the Shelton punting team, didn't have enough guys on the line of scrimmage. I think they're going to bring this one back and kick it again. See Dickie Hildebrand, he'll sort it out, but it'll be offsetting and we will punt it again.
And haven't we seen an awful lot of flags lately in this football game too?
Well, I'm wrong on this one. Shelton's going to get all three, so the opportunity of re-kicking will not take place. Derby will take the football right there.
We've got a break in the action, buddy, and let's go to our fourth quarter feature and our referee quiz with Larry Griffin.
The referee gives the following signal. Is it holding, face mask, or illegal forward pass? We'll be back after these messages with the answer. What call did you make? If you said face mask, you made the right call.
Welcome back, everyone. Well, how many of our viewers knew that that was face mask? A fairly easy call to one of the easier official calls to recognize out there.
Griff saved the easy ones till the end of the season as he hit you with the face mask. Again, I hope you've enjoyed the feature every week, giving you an opportunity to learn a little bit more about the referee signals. Another one of the innovative creations of the telemedia staff and Liz Kennard, our executive producer, and Ron Kirkcott, who is in the truck, who along with his crew have done a masterful job all year in covering these games. Hopefully we'll give you one more with the Ansonia Chargers in their quest for another state title.
Speaking about that, buddy, that's a definite. We will be covering that championship game between New London and Ansonia. Just a couple of other things to mention to our viewers, the fact that this game, if you're watching us on Friday, well, you know you're seeing a replay of this game. Also, this Shelton Derby game, a couple of other air times for it Sunday, December the 1st at 7:30, and Monday the following day, December the 2nd at 6 p.m. And we'll be airing on Sunday evening at 5 p.m. another replay of the Amity-Seymour game in the season finale for those two traditional rivals. First down for the Raiders. Bartone still in at quarterback and flinging the football. Gets it out to Shepard on the far sidelines. And Don gets a first down on the play close to the 45-yard line.
Turnout pattern that they have thrown all morning. Bartone to Shepard. Good yardage. He is wide open on the sideline. Driven out of bounds, but he picks up the first down at about the 45.
So a first down for Derby. The football at the 45. And under 8 minutes to go here in the fourth and last quarter. The game's really been decided. The only question now is the final score. And this 81st renewal between Shelton and Derby. Thanksgiving Day, 1991. A loose ball. Potke, the ball carrier. Let's see if Derby has retained possession. It looks as if they have. And one of the linemen has jumped on the football.
Dominic Buono has replaced Ben Bartone, and along with Ben, a number of other substitutions. As the handoff into Potke, Potke will be stripped of the football right there. Tackled by number 89, who knocked the football loose. That's Brian Piccirillo, the junior. And Derby was able to cover it. It'll bring up a second at the 48 of the Derby Red Raiders.
So Buono directing the Derby offense at the 48. Gives to Dave Enrollman. A little bit of misdirection. Enrollman at the 40-yard line. The 35, the 30, the 20-yard line, and runs out of bounds. It's Miller running him out at about the 20-yard line. Dave Enrollman taking the handoff. And a nice cutback by Enrollman on the play, getting it down inside the 20.
Unusual to see the Derby quarterback behind the center, but their running attack now with Buono handing the football off to Enrollman. Enrollman coming down on an excellent run inside the 20 to about the 17 or 18-yard line.
Buddy, in front of us, we don't have a camera on him right now, but Ben Bartone sitting sadly on the Derby bench. All the credit in the world for that young man coming back off the injury he had. He's a great baseball player too. He will be heard from in the future. Ben Bartone, co-captain of the Derby Red Raiders. And Roman running on first down.
Again, just the handoff. Potke with a lead block, and Roman trying to get out behind his pulling guard and picks up a couple of yards. Shelton closed it down. Second and long for the Red Raiders.
Lord out to the right side on second down, second and 11. Dominic wants to throw. Throws over the middle, has a receiver out there. It is a reception inside the 5-yard line to Ferrigno, the tight end.
Ferrigno does a great job in coming down with this throw as Buono throws it in the middle of a crowd. Buono is forced to pull up here by the defensive end and then just throws it right down the middle. Good coverage there by Darby, but the reception by Ferrigno inside the 5 there at the 4-yard line, first and goal.
First and goal, split backs for the Raiders. Buono calling signals, gives to Enrollman. Enrollman slices towards the goal line. Got to be about the 1-foot line. Goes Dave Enrollman, outstanding junior running back. He'll be back next year for the Raiders.
Potke will lead Enrollman. He is tripped over the line of scrimmage, almost gets into the end zone. He's down inside the 1-yard line. On a second down, as the Red Raiders will take a timeout here to talk to Coach DiCenzo.
So it'll be second and goal coming up for the Derby Red Raiders. We are under 6 minutes to go. The Shelton Gaels will go undefeated in their Housatonic League schedule. They'll finish the regular season with a 9-2 mark.
An excellent year. It's too bad. We hope they might have an opportunity to get into that playoff, but this football team certainly deserves the opportunity to play one more game. Their losses go to what is a 9-0 or 10-0 Notre Dame team, and not a bad team over there at Ansonia for the two losses. Guys, keep getting us on here. You're going to make us look bad here. We're guys that don't want to be on camera. The more you get us, the worse we look.
Greg Maliska checks into the Derby backfield along with Dave and Roman on second goal. Let's see if Boano takes it himself. Dominic Boano, he deserves it. There's a young man, too, and a touchdown for the Raiders. He was in a very unenviable position in the middle of this season. He stepped in, and he, I would think the Derby coaching staff would give an awful lot of credit.
Just pushes his way forward, follows his center and guards into the end zone for a score here for the Red Raiders. And they are going to get an opportunity to get rid of the footballs that they've had waiting to throw away and on the score, and at least Derby has gotten into the end zone here with about 5:45 left to go in this football game.
So Don Boano sneaks it in from 1 yard, and there's a classic Derby program kind of a player, buddy, a young man who's paid his dues, has worked very hard in practice, and they have gotten the most out of Dominic's abilities here this year, and done a nice job in relief of the injured Ben Bartone this year.
You see the cheerleaders, a few good arms in that crew as they have hoisted a large number of footballs to the crowd here on the Derby sideline. Derby has taken a timeout again, come over to the sidelines to talk to Coach DeCenzo as they get ready for a two-point play here in this football game.
Buddy, I don't want to let the opportunity slip without thanking our spotters. Two young men from the Derby Red Raiders. First of all, we have an injured sophomore lineman. That's why he's not down on the field for the Raiders, John Alfonso. And along with John spotting for us, a freshman from the freshman team, Bob Ancinelli. Anicelli. Okay. I'd get it from these guys if I don't pronounce it. Rob Anicelli. Extra point is good.
That was the longest extra point in time I've ever seen, as that one went up, and it looked like it had some help from the wind as it just made the crossbar, but it counts, and Derby will get 7 points. You see that one, the hang time on that one was about 4.2. The Red Raiders have scored, converted. They are 27-7 down to the Shelton Gaels.
5:45 remaining in this football game. And what's left to the season for both of these teams, although Buddy has mentioned it, I've mentioned it, depending upon the outcome of a couple of other games and a few other games, who knows?
A couple years ago when we talked with Eddie McCarthy at West Haven, they had to have so many things happen for them to make the playoffs that everyone said it was impossible, and boy, they made it. As you look at a group of very dejected Derby Red Raiders, as they have met a very good Shelton football team here Thanksgiving. The Red Raiders have nothing to be ashamed of in this one. The Gaels are an outstanding football team. They came here to play, and that young man certainly has carried a major part of this game. Over 218 yards on his own shoulders here this morning.
Line drive kick, it's fielded there. And dropping to the turf right there. Let's get the number. Is that Peterson? Yes, it is. Dave Peterson falls on the football. You're going to see a JV unit out there right now for the Shelton Gaels. A lot of class on both sides of the field. Tony Brancaneu, when his team had this football game, it was time to get the younger players in there. First down for the Gaels. Miller is the quarterback at the 40-yard line. Give to the tailback. That's Panagiotidis. And Panagiotidis takes it off the right side for one on the play.
Number 57.
Just the base play of this offense, a blast. Fullback kicking out at the end and then allowing Panagiotidis to come up inside. They pick up about a yard, but again,
oh, there's Greg Kashuba. Thought we had him on last week. Well, we get him on again. Derby also, Buddy, to their credit, they have a new unit there defensively, so both coaches recognizing this game is over. But Agitidas bounces it outside. The sophomore running back, Sailor, on the tackle from his backer spot.
First down.
As the coaches from both teams turn it over to the underclassmen.
Toss outside to Panagiotidis as he goes down the sideline close to that first down marker. An excellent run by the young running back who is not going to get a lot of time in there with John Eason, unfortunately, as this guy's a pretty good running back on his own right, and playing behind Eason, you're not going to get a lot of time with the football.
Miller on third and short, third and one at midfield. Panagiotidis for the first down as Shelton's just going to run the football and take the remaining clock down. Daruba on the tackle from his backer spot.
Again, Panagiotidis following this fullback for the first down yarders down at about the 46-yard line of the Derby Red Raiders.
Rob Scarduzio also on the tackle for Derby. First down for Shelton. 4:20 and the time clicking down here in the fourth quarter. Telemedia Sports, a Valley High School football game of the week. A soft Miller, a soft middle. All right, I got that right. Soft middle and Miller straight ahead for a Shelton first down.
Good read by the quarterback. Probably did it on his own as he pushed ahead right under the center and then takes the snap. Miller straight ahead for good yardage. One of the Derby Red Raiders down on the tackle. Looks like he lost his wind a little bit.
That's 26, we're told, and that would be Dave Bozzato. Dave Bozzato has come up big lately in JV games at Derby. He's really come along, and you're going to hear a lot about Dave Bozzato. He's a junior next year for Derby. Both coaches, of course, sprinkling in some of the underclassmen and also some of the seniors who may not have seen that much action. Both teams losing a lot of quality seniors. 4:10 remaining in this football game.
Eddie, while we have a chance, again, we'd like to thank all of you at home who have allowed us to come into your homes. This is the eighth season that Eddie and I have been together and really fortunate to be able to bring you some of the best high school football in the state and to show you the players in the Valley who have some outstanding athletic ability. And again, Eddie and I thank you for that opportunity. As you see the young man coming to the sidelines as he is up under his own power, and that again is always good to see. But thank you for allowing us that opportunity to bring some of the best football in the state into your living rooms every Sunday, Monday, and Friday evening.
Why is it always that the fall passes so quickly too?
It's amazing how quick the season has gone, and we've had some great games this season, and we know that we look forward to next year already, but it's certainly a great time of the year.
First down for the Gales. Panagiotidis straight ahead on the first down carry. Finally taken down by Sailor. Jim Panagiotidis, a 5'8", 156 sophomore running back.
Panagiotidis is doing a whale of a job on his own as he has picked up a couple first downs here in this drive. Coming straight ahead, following the fullback, getting good yardage behind that offensive line that the Gales have substituted for now, and they're no slouches. The backup people for the Gales are doing a creditable job of opening some holes on their own.
A lot of programs would like to have that fullback in front of them too, Ron Rich, as Panagiotidis again finds an opening off the right side. We've got a flag dropped on the play. As Scarduzio on the tackle again for Derby.
Rich is only a sophomore. I had a chance to see him from the wrong side of the field in the JV program, and he sort of ate us alive in Amity all by himself, and he's going to be a quality football player. I know they're very high on him at Shelton. You see again the handoff with Ridge leading Panagiotidis. Panagiotidis comes inside. Penalty will move the ball back. It'll be a second and 10, 3:13 left to go here in this football game, and Derby, I guess, can't wait for that clock to end. They just would like to get out of here.
Second and 11. They try Panagiotidis. But he is wrestled down at the line of scrimmage. Number 58, Tom Thompson. A fine defensive play by the Raiders right at the line of scrimmage. And Mr. Branca has received a dousing. And he's being hugged there by Dennis Bobby. You see in your picture, along with Lou D'Agostine, Leon Sylvester, all enjoying the festivities. Now let's rush and get this game over so Coach Branca could shower up, and we don't want him to get a cold.
Back to the motion. Decline. We'll bring up a second down.
Under 3 minutes to go, a lot of people leaving now, but when we look across the field, the people in orange over there, black and orange, they're staying. Mark Russell split out wide to the right side on third and 11 for Shelton at the 34 of Derby. Miller fake the pass and now runs the football, gets it down to the 30-yard line before he's taken down there by Saylor. And we've been calling Saylor's name an awful lot in the second half especially. Adam Saylor, a sophomore linebacker. Coach Charlie DeCenza, with all the adversity, he had a chance, buddy, to get in a lot of young players, both offensively and defensively, a lot of valuable game experience.
Quarterback draw. This time Miller just pulls the ball down, picks up about 4 yards inside the 30-yard line as the nose of the football is just over the 30. And there's one of the young people still up on top on the mountain as most of the people have left. Also in the stands, especially on the Derby side, have gotten an early start to Thanksgiving dinner.
A fourth down, and they pitch out to Panagiotidis, and he will come well short of the yardage for the first down. Luke Corelli on the stop for the Raiders. And the Derby Red Raiders will take over on downs, under 2 minutes to go. It is Shelton's football game. Our score right now is Shelton 27 and Derby 7.
Pitch to Panagiotidis as he tries to go to the outside. Derby closed it down very well. Derby will take over, under 2 minutes. You see Ben Bartone there, and that says it all for the Derby Red Raiders as they have played provided an outstanding effort, but today it has been the Shelton Gales that have prevailed, and Shelton will take this win home. They have deserved it. As coming to the outside is Ann Roman, and it's going to be a foot race.
Dave Ann Roman, midfield, 40-yard line, down the left sidelines, 20, and Roman in for the score. He did not go out of bounds. Dave Ann Roman. Looking for flags, there are none. He tiptoed down the left sidelines, and the junior running back has scored again for the Raiders.
And Roman just comes on the handoff, and he will get outside and then just outdistance the secondary down the sidelines. Miller is coming over. He does not have the angle. And Roman all the way on that 80-yard romp to pay dirt for the Derby Red Raiders.
So Dave and Roman tacking on another touchdown. Earlier in this quarter, it was Dominic Bolano sneaking in it from one. So the Raiders making the score more respectable as Marco Brito on the extra point attempt. It's good, and our score is 27 for Shelton and 14 for Derby. 1:17 remaining in the football game.
Once again, the recipient of the Silver Turkey Award is Judge Rado, many men present, from the Shelton Gales, number 20, John Easton.
Edward, they have just announced that the winner of the Silver Turkey is John Easton. I wouldn't be surprised if he wins another award before the end of the game, as he will collect a number of trophies for his effort today in this football game. And there he is, number 20, John Easton, the outstanding running back for the Shelton Gales. Only a junior, and I know all the coaches in the Housatonic League are going to love to look forward to defensing that young man again next year, along with Bobby Ears at fullback.
Shelton is going to be losing really along that front line offensively and defensively in terms of skill people. They got an awful lot of skill people back. They're going to lose their quarterback, and that's a big loss in Dan Field. They're going to lose Unfrick. They're going to lose their tight ends in Croc and Darby. They've got a fine wideout in Peterson. So a lot of skill players coming back, and I do know that Shelton JV program and the freshman program, very successful. As are the, we could talk about just about all our Valley schools. The Derby, I know, did very well JV-wise, and the freshmen had a very successful season for the Derby Red Raiders. So both these programs have a lot to look forward to next year and in the coming years. Kick is end over end, that is to Easton. And John is just taken down there. I think Massey got to him first, along with Potke.
Ball bounces around, Easton picks it up. Just comes straight up the field. Potke will drag him to the ground, right at around the 30-yard line. Easton slow to get up. Really didn't make it to the sidelines. You see there, he was hit pretty good, and they are now around him, John Eason just having a tremendous football game here at Ryan Field. You see as Eason picks the football up and comes back up the middle, Potke will hit him pretty good, and then he's going to get hit a second time. Potke grabs him here, and here comes the second one. You'll see it come in, and he'll get stood up right there. Good pop into John Eason as he is now up and off the field. You see him limping a little bit. He deserves the opportunity just to go over and to sit down and relax.
A little bit over 1 minute to go in this football game. First down for the Gales, just going to run out the clock. They give to the fullback, the sophomore Rich. And Rich taking Derby Red Raiders with him to midfield. Ron Rich, 6 foot, 180 pounds, sophomore fullback. Mike Thompson on the tackle for Derby.
He breaks into that secondary very quickly. He's a big guy at fullback. Remind you of Bobby Ayer. They are both similar. Almost goes the distance. He is dragged down from behind by the secondary. Nice run by that young sophomore fullback, Mr. Rich.
First down.
Ron Rich.
37 ticks remaining, and a class thing to do at this point. Miller just touches his knee down, and no sense in doing anything else offensively. Gales are going to win it. The Housatonic League champs are going to complete an untarnished 9-0 record in the Housatonic League for 1991 and end their season, their regular season, on a 9-2 mark. Derby, well, you have to look back in the record books. The last time that they had a losing season, the Raiders are going to drop to 5-6, but the Raiders will be back in 1991 as we run things out here, run the timeout. That's it. Our final score, the Shelton Gales 27 and the Derby Red Raiders 14. We'll be back right after these messages. Goodbye, everyone. Our final score is Shelton 27, Derby 14. Upcoming right now, Naugatuck Ansonia Thanksgiving Day highlights. Goodbye, everyone. At Veterans Field in Naugatuck, Ansonia and Naugatuck squared off on the football field for the 93rd time in a series dating back to the turn of the century. The Chargers won the opening coin flip and deferred their option to the second half. On the Greyhounds' opening possession, quarterback Mike Dietelbaum connected with Tim Shea to midfield. The drive eventually stalled, and Dietelbaum punted the football away. Robbie Clark fielded the punt at the 21, eluded a couple of tackles, and rambled to the Naugatuck 32-yard line. Ansonia quarterback Rich Lester went right to the air, completing a pass to Mark Gessner down to the 23. Later on a 2nd and 8, Jason Tinney on a pitch-out ran to the 13. Two plays later from the Naugatuck 11, Tinney scored on a draw. Lucian Perillo tacked on the extra point, and Ansonia led 7-0 with 7:03 remaining in the quarter. Naugatuck took over on their 44-yard line on the ensuing kickoff. Scott Carroll on a handoff from Dietelbaum carried to the Ansonia 42. Kevin Kuzma tried the other side, picking up 8 yards to the Ansonia 34. Dietelbaum on a rollout picked up another first down to the Ansonia 22. Two plays later, the Hounds tried their fullback, Paul Lucky, and he rambled to the Ansonia 12. Next, Jesse Slocum picked up the first down, slashing off the left side, down to the Ansonia 8. The drive stalled, and Dietelbaum connected on a 27-yard field goal with 2:24 to go in the first quarter. On the following kickoff, Naugatuck caught a major break when the Chargers failed to cover the football. Pete Bosco covered for the Greyhounds at the Ansonia 31. On a third down from the Ansonia 27, Dietelbaum hooked up with Brandon Hayward at the 21 for a first down. Once again, Ansonia's defense stiffened, forcing Dietelbaum to attempt a 38-yard field goal on the second play of the second quarter. Dietelbaum's kick came up short, and the score remained Ansonia 7, Naugatuck 3. On the touchback, Ansonia put the ball in play at the 20. On third down, Lester hit Clark at the 35. Clark broke free at midfield and outran the Greyhound secondary for the score. Ansonia led 13-3 with 10 minutes remaining in the first half. The game's turning point occurred on Naugatuck's next possession. On third down from their 24, Dietelbaum found Kuzma open at the Hounds' 45, and Kuzma headed towards the end zone for an apparent easy score. But wait, Tinney caught up with the sophomore, made a flying tackle inside the Ansonia one-yard line. Then disaster struck for Naugatuck when Dietelbaum fumbled the football with linebacker Jeff Press recovering for Ansonia in the end zone. Taking over on their 20, Lester handed the football to Tinney, and the junior running back did the rest, breaking tackles and making a nice cutback on the way to a 45-yard gain to the Naugatuck 35. A couple of plays later, Lester hit his tight end Fred Pettit at the Naugatuck 20. Moments later, Lester capped the drive with a touchdown pass to Gessner for the third Charger touchdown. Ansonia went into the halftime intermission with a 19-3 lead. Ansonia went to the inside running game on their first possession of the second half. First, Tinney carried up the middle to his 49-yard line. Then fullback Jamar Kelly ran the football to the Hounds' 40. Tinney followed with a run through the center of the line that advanced the football to the Naugatuck 17. Then it was Kelly's turn again. The senior captain bowled his way inside the 10. Two plays later, Lester connected with Pettit over the middle on a 9-yard scoring strike, and Ansonia led 25-3 with 9:26 left in the third quarter. On Naugatuck's first possession of the second half, Dietelbaum completed a pass to Kuzma down at the Ansonia 35. The senior quarterback lost the handle on the next play, and Ansonia recovered. That turnover led to another Ansonia score when Lester, late in the third quarter, found Tinney all alone on the Greyhound 10. Tinney waltzed into the end zone as Ansonia extended its lead to 31-3. Moving to the fourth quarter, Dietelbaum tried to rally his team. First, he connected with sophomore tight end Dave Levine on a slant over the middle to the Ansonia 35. Moments later, on a rollout, he hit Hayward over the